Welcome back to Body Talk, everybody. This is Troy Navsker with the Advanced Spine Joint and Wellness Center, episode number 5. Today, we're going to talk about the 10 weight loss discoveries. You can check us out. Go to www.finneganohio.com, or you can contact us directly at 330-242-7669. Again, today, I am accompanied by Michael Morris. Michael, again, welcome.
It's so good to be here, and it's good to be here with you, because this is a subject I think everybody's interested in.
Yeah, I think so. And we've kind of pre-framed this with the last two shows, getting into a little bit about gut health two shows ago. Last time we talked a little bit about thyroid issues, things like this. And now we're really going to get into the nuts and bolts of some of these issues that cause a lot of folks problems.
Can you briefly, if someone hasn't heard this before, when you're saying gut health, can you kind of define that again if they haven't heard? Because we broke this down really in four different pieces.
Sure.
But if someone has not heard it before, what does gut health actually mean?
Yeah, it's a difficult term, and most people have not heard this term, but or have heard this concept. But gut health really, really just comes down to the stomach and the small intestine. It has to function properly. It has to be able to break down food properly, and it has to be able to absorb food and, most importantly, nutrients properly for our bodies to be able to begin even functioning the way that they're supposed to. So it is kind of a broad term. I'm not sure there's an exact definition, but I think that's the best way I could describe it.
Right. Well, it's key because, again, if we're going on show number 5, when you had given us some information to read beforehand, gut health is something I hadn't heard that term, and it's a very base kind of sound thing. Like gut health, you think like if you're overweight, it has nothing to do with that. It is what actually is going on in your body when you're taking in food or drink.
And the term gut really doesn't have anything to do with size. It just means, you know, the gut, which is our ability to digest food. And even folks that are very thin, maybe, you know, someone that's 5'8", 100 pounds, can have an unhealthy gut and may be struggling with symptoms, which we'll talk a little bit about today. And some of those symptoms go right back to gut health.
Well, let's get into today, because we've got, this might have to be covered on two different shows.
I agree. It's a lot of information.
Yeah, because we've got 10 different pieces here. So let's get into step number one, the accountability aspect.
Sure. Yeah. When it comes to weight loss, I think one of the most important things, and a lot of folks are interested in weight loss, this is a huge topic. When it comes to weight loss, accountability, being accountable to somebody or someone really helps things. I'm sure there's thousands of folks out there listening to this that maybe have tried things before and they try things on their own, but they quickly begin to fade within a week or two because there isn't any accountability. And having a coach, you know, a true nutrition coach that has been through this, that is knowledgeable in this, that can guide an individual through this individually based on their needs is absolutely critical.
Do you think that that's why you see a lot of crash diets? I mean, I think you and I have briefly talked about this, but when you watch television all day long, there's ads, take sure. this pill or eat this, these portions. But again, there it's kind of like you're on your own. If you are a novice at losing weight or correcting your nutritional intake, there is no accountability. It's follow this plan, but you're not really learning anything. If you have a coach, you do have somebody that's, they've been there, they've corrected this for other people. I mean, that's the reason to have a coach, right?
Absolutely. I think that's spot on. I couldn't agree more. And, you know, a lot of folks that have been through maybe crash diets or have tried things that just come from a box, a bag, or a can, I think you also hit another key point, which is we haven't really learned anything. Maybe we've learned to kind of count calories, which we really don't focus on too much, but they really haven't learned a whole lot in the way or in terms of what is true health and the way that this is supposed to work to make our body do what God intended it to do.
Is a calorie a calorie? You've heard that term.
Yeah, it's
a calorie is a calorie, so it doesn't matter, right?
Well, a calorie is a calorie. And, you know, I heard someone say it's not about how much you eat as compared to what you eat.
Right.
And I think that's really important. And that's what this really comes down to is what are we putting in that can really cause problems? And, you know, a coach that really understands nutrition for what it should be to make the body perform the way that it should. And I really love the term eat to perform. There's a whole system based on that. But we want to eat to make our body perform the way that it should.
There was a guy that played in the NFL that I remember. He was dating a friend of mine. And I remember what he said was, "I don't eat for taste. I eat for fuel."
Sure.
And I thought, well, what does that mean? After reading these things, I understand, like, if you are getting more positive or healthy nutrients and stripping away the processed stuff,
yes,
you do feel more aware. You're not drinking coffee all day to stay awake. You are alert. I got it, but I didn't quite understand what that meant at the time. I mean, that's kind of what you're talking about.
That's
right?
Exactly it. And, you know, a fun analogy is imagine, you know, a race car, you know, like a NASCAR or an Indy car. These machines are designed to run on really clean fuel, and they're going to perform extremely well, driving over 200 miles an hour for a long period of time without breakdowns. Our bodies are designed that way as well. They're designed to have good, clean fuel put in them to be able to perform at a high level, kind of like that machine. And if you kind of look at what processed food is, anything from a box, bag, or can, or if it's been changed from the way God initially built the thing or made the food, it's been processed. And that's almost like taking diesel and putting it into this NASCAR and expecting it to perform correctly. It just isn't going to happen. And you're not going to be able to, you're not going to be able to race a machine like that. Does that make sense?
It totally does. And I think the fuel analogy is the best way to look at it because, the weight loss programs you see, those are revenue generating.
Right.
They're revenue generating machines. Let's put it that way. Versus your body. Everybody's body is different.
Mm-hmm.
How you process, whether it's wheat, dairy, whatever it is. And I know you're against dairy. Mm-hmm. We'll talk about that. But these quick fixes, you may look good on the outside for a short amount of time, but you could still be unhealthy inside.
Sure.
Right?
And health doesn't have a look. You know, you can't look at someone and say they're healthy. And one of the analogies I have here is I'm sure all of us have heard before somebody that had a heart attack, okay, that looked healthy, felt healthy, didn't feel any problems up until the day they had a heart attack. Well, the day before, they necessarily didn't have any symptoms or didn't feel any problems, or maybe, quote unquote, felt totally normal, but that artery was still clogged. So they weren't
healthy. What do they call that? The widow maker? Like, correct. You don't see it coming?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And again, you can't look at someone that's physically fit and say they're healthy. If you look at a lot of these bodybuilders and things like that, they're full of toxins from some of the supplements and things that they're doing. And a lot of them are still eating a lot of prepackaged food. Some are actually doing things right, but they may look good, but necessarily doesn't mean that they feel well or have a state of health.
Interesting question, at least for me, maybe no one else. You have coaches for bodybuilding or athletes,
sure,
in that, but they're not nutritionists. They're not trained. They don't have a background like you would in this. Those people that are training for sports specific or bodybuilding,
mm-hmm,
they need to clean this out of them, right? I mean, I don't mean the supplements. I'm talking about the food they're eating because a lot of it is processed.
Sure.
Right. So they have to kind of reboot their system anyway, right? Because they're going to have a problem when they're doing more of like a crash diet, like a plan.
Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm. But then they balloon back up.
Yeah, and there is some yo-yoing with that, with folks that do have to cut weight for like wrestling and things like that. And I get it, like there's certain sports, they have to do those things. But again, you know, I don't know if they're necessarily getting the proper nutrients they need, and what kind of foods are they eating as they're trying to perform. And any athlete that's trying to perform at a high level is going to need good fuel. And, you know, you've probably seen some of the t-shirts out there, you know, that are out there now, you know, eat, train,
right,
refuel, and do it again. And a lot of folks do. And it's just, what kind of fuel are we putting in?
So as far as, you know, we talked about a calorie is a calorie. That's not necessarily true. What's the new fad with macros? Have you heard that term?
Sure.
Where people are counting macros, not calories.
Yeah, I really, I think that people will have success with it, counting macros. I think that you can have some success with those things. But again, are we really, really teaching good nutrition by just looking at a macro count?
Well, it seems more like it's get your calculator out and figure it out.
Sure.
It is not really what's balancing your body with what nutrients are you getting.
Right.
It's more of a plan that's been come up with because I know you can cut weight doing this. But it is a short-term fix versus what you're discussing is a lifestyle.
A lifestyle and a long-term. You know, we don't want a Band-Aid.
Right.
We want to teach people what to do to change their health profile for the long term. You know, so what can we do to change them? Let's take, for instance, somebody that's diabetic and maybe they've been diabetic for 3 years. I love kind of going backwards and saying, OK, well, what was your life like 5 to 7 years ago before you became diabetic? And how has that changed in the past few years since you've become diabetic? And if life has changed this much where you now have no energy, your sleep is poor, you have neuropathy in your feet, pain and burning, what does that look like 5 years from now if we don't do something about this?
Right.
What does the long term look like if we just continue to let this disease process occur? we can actually stop that in its tracks and actually begin to reverse a lot of these things with proper eating.
And you have, because I think we talked about people that have been diabetics that you've worked with. That change has got to be phenomenal. I mean, for them, yes, but also you put them on that course. I mean, you're smiling now talking about it.
Yeah, it's fun. It's life-changing. It is absolutely life-changing when you see some of these folks get off of their insulin or get off of whatever medicine it is that they're attempting to get off of. It's life-changing for them, and it's disease-altering. So we have altered the course of the disease rather than now just managing it with the medicines and letting it continue to take its course.
Well, again, you said rather than managing. And managing, I think people need to understand, there are a lot of drugs that have side effects, but they will quell kind of some of the other issues you're having, like diabetic medication. It's better to try to rid yourself of diabetes than to take medication and kind of wean off it, right?
I mean, sure.
You're looking at the optimum health and the optimal results for a body versus we just want to get you through the next 90 days or you've got your high school reunion coming up or something like that.
Right. Yeah, we really, really look to change people's lives. Now, we have lots of folks that come in and say, hey, I got this cruise I'm going on. Hey, I got to fit in this wedding dress. Of course, that's always going to continue to happen, and we're happy to help with those folks. But along the way, they're going to learn that we're really looking to change their health for the remainder of their life.
Let's go to step two. So we've got food and digestion. We've minimally touched on that today.
Yeah.
But really, what does that mean?
Yeah. So food and digestion, there are lots of foods that a lot of folks just don't realize. And if you kind of sift through here, a lot of folks just don't realize how many different foods impact their ability to actually digest food and break down foods and then properly absorb. So, you know, this second weight loss discovery that we have on here, food and digestion, really begins to break down some of these in the smaller little chunks for people to, quote unquote, digest mentally.
Right.
Yeah.
That's a funny way to put it, but it is true. As far as digestion, you and I have talked about gluten allergies and the issues with dairy. The breakdown, I'm interested for myself. Uh-huh. Obviously, you and I have discussed this off the air, but when you have a gluten intolerance, how do people, first of all, find out they even have that issue?
Well, there are tests that can be run for gluten sensitivity. So there are blood tests that can be done. You can also do some testing where you actually do some biopsies, by scoping and doing biopsies. Gastroenterologists will sometimes scope to do biopsies, but there are some blood tests that can be done or, a good clinician, just historically talking to someone can oftentimes figure it out and spare the blood test and or a potential, minor surgery, but minor is major in my opinion.
Any surgery is not recommended.
Absolutely. Which if we can avoid it. Yeah.
Right.
If there are things that we can pick up on in a patient's history to go, listen, gluten, it's just got to go. Easiest thing to do is just get rid of it. Yeah, we get rid of it. And for a period of time, if someone comes back 3 weeks later and they go, listen, I got rid of gluten and my energy is off the charts, I no longer feel bloated. And oh, by the way, I've lost 5 pounds too.
Right.
This is great. Then you go, listen, it's pretty easy to make the diagnosis of a gluten sensitivity at that point and say, let's just stay off.
But you would recommend getting rid of gluten to begin with because of the amount of processed. I mean, it's not the bread that you would have gotten 60 years ago.
Sure. Right.
So there, you don't really know what's in it. The issue may not be the wheat itself. It may be what else is in it.
Sure. And it has to do a lot of with the processing. The way that we're making these things now is what's really created gluten to be a big issue. And the way that bread is made, it goes from wheat to bread within hours rather than, the days and weeks that it took to get it there before. And that has dramatically altered the ability of our food to be full of the nutrients that it's designed to have rather than what we've sped things up to be that we're now missing.
I think that's the part where when you see any of these documentaries about how food, like Fed Up, the one with Katie Couric, and you see these things, and I was just watching them as a casual, like, hey, I'm folding laundry, and then you watch this, and you end up, your mouth's hanging open, like, that's what we're actually eating?
Yeah.
That's the concern, but I think when people are looking at their overall health, again, it's what they look like on the outside, and like you said, you can't look at somebody and say they're healthy.
Yeah.
Everything could be wrong inside,
yeah.
But if you correct what's inside, it impacts the outside as well.
100%. All health starts from the inside. So, when we talk with folks, even folks that are just in pain, for that matter, oftentimes, even though folks are in pain, maybe they've been everywhere, they've tried things. Sometimes we go right back to gut health and that fixes someone that's been in pain for a long time. Like these folks that struggle with fibromyalgia and these other chronic pain issues, rheumatoid arthritis, oftentimes we just go straight to the gut. And believe it or not, as we reduce inflammation in the gut, reduces inflammation in their body, pain goes away. And again, it goes right back to number two, toxins.
Part of number two is that America is severely malnourished.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Why is that? I mean, as a clinician,
yeah,
you see this on a day in, day out basis.
Right.
And what's going on with their gut health then turns into they've got arthritic conditions, their sure. back hurts, whatever it may be, they feel fatigue.
Yeah.
Where's that malnutrition come from?
Well, it comes from, it goes right back to the very simple things again, which is, you know, here we've got this processed food. All of the processed food, a lot of it just simply has, it's got calories and it's fortified. We have vitamins added to it. So we have synthetic vitamins and we have calories. And basically what's occurring is our bodies, we're getting calories, which will keep us alive, but we aren't getting nutrients. We aren't getting the micronutrients. Like you mentioned macronutrients. I love talking about the macros, but what we're missing, and this is why I'm not a big fan of this macronutrient thing, is that we're still missing micronutrients. So without micronutrients, disease still develops, such as thyroid disorders, hypothyroidism. Many folks are, you know, being treated for thyroid issues and they still don't feel well. And it's actually a micronutrient deficiency. So what's really occurring, the bottom line here with these things in food and digestion is we're just not getting the micronutrients our body needs to be able to function properly. And we're loading ourselves full of toxins. So, you know, these things that are added to our foods that just aren't designed to be there.
Well, even including junk food. I mean, I think junk food is a really lazy term.
Yeah.
Because now junk food isn't, it's not a bag of chips. It's, this is fat free or whatever. Like they've kind of taken the stigma because you knew what junk food sure. was before. Now, when you go to the store, you're like, but this has vitamin C added to it. Yeah. So it's okay to eat this donut. You yeah. know, that kind of thing where when you take the label and change it, you yeah. feel like you're eating healthier. But you're not. You're yeah. just looking at a label and going, I can absolve myself of the guilt.
Yeah, this was really fun. One of my other favorite ones to pick on here in this one, high fructose corn syrup. Okay, extremely pro-inflammatory. This is a terrible, terrible additive to a lot of our foods. So my wife and I were walking through Costco. This is probably 2-3 months ago, maybe a little bit longer than that. We're walking through Costco and I just happened to look over at a box of cereal. I'm not going to name the name of it, but a box of cereal and it said no high fructose corn syrup. And I was like, wow, that's great. So I'm like, well, I want to pick it up and see what they've got in it then. So I pick up the box and I look on there and the second ingredient was corn syrup. But it just wasn't high fructose.
Right.
Great trick. Yeah. Great marketing trick. So I looked at that and I was like, come on. They can legally say that. No high fructose corn syrup. And it isn't high fructose, but it's still corn syrup.
Right.
And it's still pro-inflammatory.
But again, that was my point is you can go in and think you're doing something right.
Correct.
Because you're looking at the front of the box. You right. actually have to look at the ingredients on the side of the box.
Gotta know what you're looking at. Yeah. And these are things that I don't recommend any of. If there's an ingredient list, typically I'm going to tell folks if it has more than one ingredient, we're not going to eat it. Right. So is it an apple? Yeah. Then that's good. But if it has a list of 30 things, we're probably not going to recommend
it. And
that.
If you don't know what three of those things are, you shouldn't touch it, right?
Correct.
Because I'm not a scientist, but I'm looking at this and I'm like, there's a lot that went into this wheat thin.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
And that's not to pick on wheat thins. They're fantastic.
Well, and if you look at a lot of the recipes, like I've been posting some of our recipes. We have a website with thousands and thousands of recipes that our folks in our programs have access to. And I've been slowly just kind of posting those, some of those on our Facebook feed. And if you look, all of those things are basically just fresh foods. So things that you would need to go buy each and every day that are fresh foods that we're now going to put together to make something really, really good.
We need to take a break because we've gone almost 19 straight minutes.
Wow, that went fast.
I know, but we're two in. I swear, we're going to cover this in two and a half shows.
Sure.
You're listening to Body Talk. We'll be right back.
The body and confidence you've always desired is within your grasp with Advanced Spine, Joint, and Wellness. Advanced Spine, Joint, and Wellness optimizes your health while shedding excess pounds. Following the Club Reduce Weight Loss Program creates the body you desire based on a complete nutritional analysis and medical supervision. Get real guaranteed fast results that last. Advanced Spine, Joint, and Wellness provides a personal and detailed program to change your life. Call 1-833-2-GET-THIN or visit thinagainohio.com to speak to your weight loss consultant today.
Hi, this is Marty Reed, and I'm the owner of Frog Hauling. We are Columbus's only green residential mini dumpster service. If you want to clean your garage, you want to clean your basement, or maybe clean your yard, give Frog Hauling a call. 258-3764. At Frog Hauling, we also service contractors. And if only the best product will do for your customer, give Frog Hauling a call. Visit us at froghauling.com or call us at 614-258-3764.
Hi, I'm Todd Schmidt, president of Renovations Unlimited. At Renovations Unlimited, we provide the highest quality in home remodeling services in and around Columbus. Our commitment is to exceed quality professional craftsmanship with the absolute best remodeling experience. At Renovations Unlimited, we don't just do kitchen and bathroom remodeling. Design build projects are the cornerstone of our business. Every day, we create dream home experience with everything we do. See for yourself. The home of your dreams awaits you at renovationsunlimited.com.
Enjoy putt and play all summer long. Come to play with up to four friends for less than $5 a day. Play unlimited rounds of miniature golf with the summer club card. Go to puttandplayfuncenter.com for details.
Mark, it's our 40th year at Greenscapes. How do we get the word out about the premier design-build landscapes that Greenscapes creates?
The radio?
Radio? How can people see our premier landscapes that you design on radio?
Our 24-hour showroom is available at greenscapes.net, where people can see what we create every day.
Greenscapes.net. Hey, great idea, Mark.
Greenscapes.net displays all of our projects and also gives you timely garden tips.
Mark, as Central Ohio's premier landscape company, I think Greenscapes is going to have a fabulous 40th year.
Grandview Dental Care wants to see you smile. Invisalign makes your perfect smile all that you can imagine. Grandview Dental Care patients rave about how Invisalign has made them say, "Why didn't I do this sooner?" This easily affordable, life-changing smile can be yours at Grandview Dental Care. Invisalign care provided from a high-tech, knowledgeable, and caring staff that excels in Invisalign smile makeovers. What's holding your smile back? Call 486-7378 or visit GrandviewDentalCare.com.
Get out to putt and play all summer long and play 18 holes of miniature golf, batting cages, and a brand new arcade. Check out the party rooms for birthday parties and events. Go to puttandplayfuncenter.com for details.
Okay, everybody, Troy Nafsker again with the Advanced Spine Joint and Wellness Center in Medina. You can check us out at www.thinagainohio.com. You can contact us directly, 330-242-7669. I'm back with Michael Morris, and today we've been talking about our weight loss discoveries, and we're on number two, which is just toxic foods. Michael,
right.
Here we go.
So we kind of touched on process. Okay, just strictly gluten process. Here's my question.
Mm-hmm.
Coffee.
Mm-hmm.
What's your opinion on coffee?
So coffee, it's another one that's a GI or an irritant to the GI system. So coffee, there are some health benefits to it. There are some good natural antioxidants in it, and there are some things that are beneficial to us. But what happens is most Americans, 2, 3, 4 cups, now we're a pod in and we've got a problem. And a lot of folks, and maybe this isn't the best way to say it, but a lot of folks will drink coffee and 30 minutes later, they're running to the bathroom. Mm. And the reason being is it is a GI irritant. It irritates the GI tract in excess amounts, and it does cause inflammation in the GI tract. It also interacts with our adrenal glands. That caffeine, if we're getting too much of it, can actually cause some adrenal fatigue, which we're going to be talking a couple shows down the road as we get through this and sift through on hormones and what adrenal fatigue can do to limit the ability of someone to lose weight and or have energy and function the way they want to. But coffee is extremely irritating to the GI tract.
Is it because of the fatigue? It slows down weight loss, right? Because if you're fatigued, your body is not in sync, so it can't really expel the things it has to the right way, but also provide energy, right? Because if I'm expelling something, I'm using my energy, right?
Yeah, and you know, fatigue. We'll talk about this one too. Symptoms are another portion of this weight loss report that we have. But symptoms, fatigue is a symptom. So I like to talk about symptoms as like a check engine light in a car. You know, any kind of symptom you have is like a check engine light in a car saying something's not right. And a lot of folks will just go, well, I'm getting older, so I should be tired. Well, not necessarily.
That's like giving up, right? So instead of, that's my excuse for not really looking inward and taking care of it. It's fine. I'll just deal with it.
Sure. Yeah. And you know, a lot of folks just adapt to it. They go, well, I'm getting older. I'm tired. I'll just adapt my life to being fatigued. Well, fatigue is a symptom. So if you have fatigue, there's probably a reason for it. And if you don't like it and you want more energy, there are ways to do it naturally.
Well, let me ask you, so coffee and sweeteners kind of go hand in hand. Is it, if you look at sweeteners, you have, is it stevia, and then you have mm-hmm. Equal and Sweet and Low. Mm-hmm. Is it the, I can tell you as a as an avid coffee drinker, I don't drink it as much anymore.
Yeah.
But I was drinking a pot and a half a day, because I'd be in my office and just constantly cranking away, and I'm going to burn the midnight oil and do this. What I found more was, it wasn't the coffee, it was the sweetener I was putting in there, because it became addictive, that sweet flavored mm-hmm. over and over. I'm not really drinking coffee anymore. Now I'm just drinking like a glazed donut in it. You know what I mean? Because you're adding creamer and everything else.
Yeah.
That is the, that artificial flavor
yeah.
is what you're craving more than the coffee. Because I think if people just had to drink black coffee, it'd be one cup a month, it'd be good enough.
Yeah. And it's funny, the sugars or the artificial sweeteners that we put in there, and sugar for that matter, sugar is unbelievably highly addictive. There's a really fun study on sugar and comparing sugar to cocaine. And they got these rats hooked on both cocaine and sugar, and trying to get them off, they were actually more addicted to sugar than they were cocaine. So it's a highly addictive substance. But sugar is pro-inflammatory, as are all of the zero calorie sweeteners. And a lot of folks that come in and want to lose weight, it's one of the first things I take away from them.
Is the artificial or the sugar?
The artificial and the sugar. And most of them are already drinking these zero calorie drinks, which are no more beneficial than if they were drinking something with sugar in it.
But the chemical is harder for your body because it's a chemical to break down, correct? So that causes gut inflammation, because it's not a, your body doesn't really know what to do with it. It's not a sugar. It's not a naturally occurring substance, right?
Right. It's not naturally occurring, and it is a chemical. So if you really think about it, we are putting a chemical into our body that's not designed to be there. And it was designed, it was, you know, manufacturer engineered to be like sugar, but just with no calories. And, you know, aspartame, neotame, sucralose, all of these things are chemicals that are extremely irritating to the GI system, but they also stimulate insulin production. So we're making ourselves fat storers by using these artificial sweeteners.
And it also causes things like acid reflux, right? Because, I mean, it all, you always say this, and I say this when I'm not with you, when people are like, oh, I don't feel so well. And I'm like, how's your gut? It's all gut health, right?
It is.
So if I'm putting this chemical in, the body is saying, I don't know what to do with it. So it's got to go out one way or the other, right? So Sure. It's causing that acid reflux to build up. And then people are taking Nexium or all that to quell the issue now, not to solve the overall problem.
Yeah, right? It certainly contributes to the issue. And one of my favorites to treat when it comes down to gut health is acid reflux. And that was my personal testimonial. I think we talked
about. That's right.
Yeah, that brought me in to learn about gut health. And a chiropractor who was actually, smugly smiled and fixed me of reflux for years just by taking away some of the things I was doing nutritionally and modifying those. And I've never had it since.
I just think it's amazing the little things, the little tweaks you can make. Because again, if you get rid of the artificial sweetener, and your gut health gets better, you're going to lose weight because you're not storing that.
Correct.
Right? So, and your butt, and you're not getting sick from it.
Yeah.
But those are things that you're not taught. I mean, in this society, it is zero calorie or low calorie. That doesn't necessarily mean it's beneficial.
Right. And you know what? We're not taught that. But you know what else is funny as well is our medical providers also are not taught this. You know, as a PA, a physician assistant, I got zero education on nutrition through school. And that's also the same with everybody's doctor out there. So your medical doctor and your doctor of osteopath, they have zero nutrition training through school. So this is not something that we're trained well on. And it's not something we're well educated on. And you're starting to see this trend in healthcare where doctors are actually becoming very frustrated just by prescribing, because we really don't feel as if we're changing anybody's disease progression.
You're not going to believe this, but we've run out of time for today.
Already.
So we are going to address this in a second show,
mm-hmm.
Which you can watch on Facebook. Why don't you know them how they can
find we're on Facebook Live right now. This will post to our feed. You can just go on Facebook. You can search Advanced Spine, Joint, and Wellness.
Also on YouTube.
Also on YouTube, correct. It'll go on YouTube. And again, you can just go to YouTube and search Advanced Spine, Joint, and Wellness. I do post these over to Google. So they are on Google as well. You can just go Google Body Talk and it shows right up on a Google search. And you'll also find it on Twitter. So you can find us on Twitter, Advanced Spine Joint Wellness.
Why don't you sign off? If people are still watching on Facebook, we're going to go to part two.
Part two. This is Troy Nafs here with Body Talk. Again, you can find us www.finnegan.ohio.com or contact us directly 330-242-7669 and we'll carry on next time and we'll see you then.
You've been listening to a Morris Media production.